Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at using layers and masks in Pixelmator. So let's open up a nice little picture of a beach here in Pixelmator. And then in addition, let's open up another image here that's kind of a star field with a comet in it. And let's use these two very contrasting images to demonstrate layers and masks. So I'm going to go into this one and I'm going to select the entire thing and I'm going to go into here and paste it. And then I'm going to close its original one. So I've got the two images in one now. And the way I know that is if I go to View and Show Layers, I'll get this list of layers and I can see that I've got two different layers here. One is the beach and the other is the star field. So I've named the layers here. I just double click on the name in the layers panel here and I can name it stars and beach. Now we know what we're dealing with. And only stars is visible. It has this check mark. Now I'm going to use a clipping mask here as my first example. It's a very simple type of masking. I'm going to use the shape tool here. I'm going to create a rounded rectangle shape. And I'm going to just put that here underneath the stars layer. So now it's hidden by stars. I'm going to select the stars layer and I'm going to say I want there to be a clipping mask for this layer. And sure enough, when I do that, you can see there's a little arrow there and it points down to the next layer. And you can see that the stars layer is masked using the shape layer. So I only see what is visible by where there's some sort of color in the shape layer. So I can move this layer around and it will reveal a different part of the image. That's a really simple form of masking, the clipping mask. Now I could select this layer and delete it and instead create another layer and let's use a brush tool here. I'm going to use a pretty big brush there. I'm going to create a new layer and in this layer I'm going to draw. And it doesn't matter the color, it's just the intensity. So white versus yellow here or white versus black. I'm going to move this layer below just like I did the shape layer. Select stars and then say create clipping mask. You can see I can see what is only visible where there is some sort of color as opposed to white for this layer here. I can draw more and you can see I can reveal even more of this. So you can do all sorts of different things to reveal this layer using this layer below it with a clipping mask. Now what's not revealed is in fact just transparent. So if I turn the beach layer back on you can see it appears there and I'm kind of punching holes through the beach layer. So I can actually select in here and delete and then instead draw in part of the sky back there. Let me actually I use a selection tool. I use this line selection tool here and I will create an area in this layer that kind of follows where the sky would be. So let me start here, draw to here. I won't try to get it perfect just now, but you get the general idea. Down to here and finish it. And then I'm going to use Option Command F, which is for fill right there. So I'm going to fill it with a color. So I filled that with yellow. So after I've done with the fill there, you can see that I've got the sky now replacing the original blue sky that was there in the background. And that's using a clipping mask. Now let's undo a bunch here and get back to before we applied the clipping mask. There we go. So now we've just got back to the two layers. I just did that by hitting Command Z a bunch of times. And I'm going to create another type of mask. I'm going to control click on this layer here and I get the contextual menu. I can also use the little menu there. And I'm going to add a layer mask. So a layer mask actually splits the little image up here into two parts. You've got the image itself and you've got the mask area for that particular layer. And it's all white, meaning the entire thing is filled with color, so it's going to show everything that's here. So if I want to actually remove part of this, I would simply paint it, but using a color like, say, black is the easiest to visualize. So I'm going to go and paint there, and you see as I paint black, look in there, you can see the little black squiggle there. I'm actually revealing part of the beach here. So I could say, create a little like beach-like space here that is shown. So I'm basically removing this part of the star field so it reveals what's underneath. You can see I can turn off the beach there and it's just a hole that I've created in the star field. Now what's really cool about this is it doesn't have to be black and white, literally. You don't have to have areas that are whole through the image and an area that's opaque. You can actually blend things like this. So for instance, if I were to use the tool here for creating a blend, and I'm going to bring up the gradients here and use something normal, white to black there, I can actually draw in here. And notice I still have the mask selected. Not the regular image, not this layer, but this mask. I can actually draw something like that, and you can see how the gradient, which you can see here, the white part is showing the star field and the black part is basically a hole through it that you can see the beach. So I could do something really cool, like for instance put a hole that goes from the top here and gradually fades in to the beach there. And now you kind of get, you look like you got a beach that's looking onto a star field, or it may actually even be better to just go right here to the edge of the beach like that, or even just right to the edge of the horizon there. And now you kind of look like you've got this star field here mixed in with that blue sky. Now notice there's that little link thing between these two here. That means that the image and the mask are linked together. So if I switch to the move tool here and I try to move them, you can see both move at the same time, which may be what you want a lot of time. But you can click here on the link to unlink them. So now I can only move one independent of the other. So now with the actual star field image selected, I can move the star field and the mask will remain the same. Since I'm not using the bottom part here, I can bring this up and actually bring the comet part that was in the bottom of that into view. And now you can see the comet here in that, creating an even more surreal type of image with this comet here in the background of a kind of a combination day-night sky. So using the layer mask and clipping mask, it's really tricky, I find. I have a lot of trouble remembering which one goes on top of the other one and which color is the one that's opaque and which one that creates transparency. So I encourage you to play around with this. Grab some sample images. Just grab some images off the different websites just to play around and get good at using it before you need to use it on one of your projects or just for fun. I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.